we can confirm that the Chinese Communist Party did all that it could to make sure that the world didn't learn in a timely fashion about what was taking place. This is an enormous crisis created by the fact that the Chinese Communist Party reverted to form, reverted to the kinds of disinformation, the kinds of concealment that authoritarian regimes do.
Today, we recognize World Press Freedom Day, where we honor the critical role of an independent media. As the world faces the COVID-19 pandemic, the work of journalists in helping disseminate timely and accurate information to the public is more important than ever.
The United States is committing an additional $130 million in global health and refugee assistance, bringing our total devoted to fighting COVID-19 to more than $900 million in more than 120 countries. Congress has provided $2.4 billion in total. Whether it's our work in countering diseases like HIV, AIDS, malaria, TB, and now COVID-19, the State Department is very focused on saving lives. We still continue to implore the Chinese government to turn over the samples to allow Westerners in to look at these labs. We still need information, not only to work on this particular crisis, but to do everything we can to take down the risk that something like this can happen again. Seventy-five years ago, the Allies triumphed over Nazi Germany, ending the war in Europe. We honor American men and women who fought on faraway battlefields and worked in factories at home to keep the arsenal of democracy going.